Hello, Maker Melissa, Maker Melissa's Lab. I'm starting a multi-part build series of a CNC router, and in this video we'll be covering the electronic components. Let's get started. CNC stands for Computer Numerically Controlled, and a CNC router is basically a robotically controlled router that will cut grooves into material in a specific pattern. It is similar to a 3D printer, but instead of laying down filament, it will cut away material such as wood, metal, or plastic. So the router that I am actually going to be building, it's called the Indie Mill, and it's actually made by another YouTuber, and I'll go ahead and link to that, which has some really good informational videos on the actual build and the steps that you need to do. There's some differences, like mine will have a beefier spindle. I'm going to go over various options that I had considered, starting with the CNC controller. A CNC controller is basically a small computer that controls the movements of the machine. You can actually directly control it with a desktop computer, as it used to be done, but the way I'm going to build it is going to be similar to a 3D printer in that the computer will send commands to the CNC controller, and the CNC controller will control the movements of the machine. This isn't ideal in terms of the reaction speed of the CNC, but it is a lot cheaper, and I do plan on upgrading in the future. The CNC controller was the part I had deliberated about the most, and that was because I wasn't sure if I wanted to directly control the CNC with the computer, or if I wanted to have an intermediary board controlling it. In the end, I decided to go with the intermediary board due to the lower cost because I already had the cost of building the CNC itself. This is the board that I first was considering. This is the board by RatM Motor. It's their USB CNC board. It is a clone of the Planet CNC, and the one I got came with this little controller here. It did not have a serial number on here like it was supposed to, so I went to go contact their support. Their website's still not up at this point, and so I was unable to use the board, but I don't really feel comfortable using it anyways. Another board that I had considered using for CNC is the SKR 1.3. It's the same one I had in my Ender 3 printer, and I think it's actually a pretty good option, but there isn't a lot of documented use of this, and I had some other options I wanted to try. So the next board I have here is actually the Indie Shield. This is by the same creator as the Indie Mill, and I have it attached to an Arduino Uno. One thing I like about this one is, besides having the connections for the different motors on here, is there are spindle directions, spindle enable lines here, and with some research I found that I should be able to use those two lines in order to control the spindle speed. So this one has just enough of what I need. This is the Ramps board, and it's meant to go on an Arduino Mega, so it has some more I/O on it, but ultimately I decided that it was going to be too hard to try and interface with the stepper motors on here, and so I'm not going to actually be using this. The other board that I considered using was the Synthetos Tiny G board, and unfortunately while I was trying to test that, I ended up shorting it and damaging the chip, and it was pretty much useless at that point. And I realized I did not want to go with an integrated board because then you have to kind of get rid of the entire board and get a whole new one. I have the external stepper motor drivers here. What the stepper motor driver does is it allows the CNC controller to send a small voltage about what it wants the motor to do, and then the driver will actually drive the motor itself with a much larger voltage. If we had the CNC controller trying to directly control the stepper motor itself, it wouldn't be very powerful, and it could possibly backfeed electricity and damage it. These are the TV6600s, and they will work great for the needs that I have, which is going to be driving these NEMA 23 stepper motors. The stepper motors will actually go ahead and drive the movement of the CNC itself so that it can move the spindle to various positions and cut it in the shapes that it needs to. This is similar to the way a 3D printer works. The CNC will make multiple passes and actually cut it in progressively deeper grooves in order to achieve the shape that it needs to. For a size comparison, this is a NEMA 23 and this is a NEMA 17. So as you can see, I have four of these and I have for the stepper motor drivers. The spindle here is a 2.2 kilowatt spindle. The spindle is the part of the CNC that holds the bit that does the actual cutting. And the reason I went with this over the 1.5 kilowatt is it has the E22 size collet, which goes up to like a half inch here. It allows me to hold a wider variety of different cutting bits. This one that I have is a water-cooled spindle, so I don't have to worry about a fan on here. I do have to run lines out to a pump. By using a real spindle instead of a router, it allows me to control the speeds and use a wider variety of materials. And to control the spindle, I have a VFD or variable frequency drive. This one will take 120 volts. This has some connections in order to hook up for the power, and it also will have some additional connections in order to hook to the board to control it. For power supplies, I actually have two different power supplies. This one is a little 36 volt power supply, and this will actually be powering the external stepper drivers here. That'll make it so that the stepper motors themselves have a lot more holding power. And then I'm also using this 12 volt power supply. It's one I actually had from a previous 3D printer. It was the one that I had upgraded to the Prusa Bear. I'm gonna be making use of the switch and this plug here. I'm using this as a separate power supply as opposed to using a buck converter because I didn't want to have all that extra 24 volts going into heat. I have this little probe here for calibrating the milling bit to the right height and everything, so we can go ahead and touch the top or the sides here. I have this wire for connecting the stepper motors here. I have these plugs here so that I can hook up these four steppers. I can do another one that goes to the spindle and one more to do something like the probe here if I want to, or whatever else. I hadn't quite decided on that yet. The laptop is going to be the component that runs the software that allows me to define the tool paths and send commands to the CNC controller. Once I have built the main CNC, I will cover the software in another video. I'd like to thank my Patreon supporters, and if you'd like to support me, you can go to patreon.com/makermelissa. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video, I'm going to be mounting the electronics in this case here. And so if you want to be sure to be notified when that video comes along, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching. It's like a dance move.